fingers would be entwined and the thumbs would be crossed. The right below the left thumb. These are the mudras which you can practice daily for unblocking the chakras. Now we move to the crystals. We have brought some crystals. Now what actually crystals do? So frankly, see there are two theories about crystals. If we go about the scientific aspect, earth is actually 75%. The earth is, there are a lot of mineral traces which are found on the earth. And most of the minerals have the major constituent of silicon dioxide in them. Silicon dioxide is also an important body constituent which is found in us. So it is not a very confirmed theory, but what is said is silicon dioxide plays an important role because since it's a main element, trace element which is found in practically all the minerals, if you have a deficiency of minerals, there are chances that there is also a deficiency of silicon dioxide in your body. It is needed for performing the internal bodily functions. Pure crystals or rock crystals have the content of silicon dioxide in them. So when you keep crystals, when you touch the crystals, they work on a scientific level because they help you to, you know, they are a source of silicon dioxide because it is pure and natural. They are not man-made. That is one advantage. Second is they have a crystalline or a molecular structure which helps them to collect energy, store energy, and then focus this energy into a person's magnetic field. They work in two ways. They have their own energy. When you squeeze or when you press or when you hold a crystal, there is a piezoelectrical process which happens where the crystals release their own energy. They don't have that, they are not own forces of energy, but they reflect. So what basically they do is, they take in the universal energies, they stock it, they amplify it, and then they tune it to the person's aura. So they are the channels which actually help you to connect to the universal energies. They actually help you to get universal energy. They are the contact sources. Now, there are several crystals in which white quartz or white crystal is actually called as a master crystal. The reason behind that is, since it's a pure white light, it has got all the spectrum band intact. All the seven colors of the spectrum will be intact in a pure white crystal. That is why it is called as a master symbol. But otherwise, depending on your requirement, depending on your need, every crystal has its own molecular structure. According to that, yeah, this is a white crystal, white quartz. You get it in various forms. There are raw forms which are called as clusters. There are lasers or pencils. There are healing sticks. There are dowsing rods. Or you can use it in the form of pendants. There are several ways in which a crystal can be used. White crystal is generally called an all-purpose crystal because it has got all the seven colors. But again, depending upon the person's ailment, if you personally feel that you have certain ailments which show that your particular chakra is blocked, then you can use that related crystal to help. Have you circulated the crystals? Or you can just show. Okay. Now here we say the base chakra. So we use crystal like this. There is black onyx, tourmaline or ruby. So what I am having here in my hand is called tourmaline. This is a ruby. Ruby stone which you use. This is in a lesser, it is not a very precious form of ruby. It's a raw form of ruby. For the Swadhisthan chakra, they use orange crystals like carnelian or orange agate. For the yellow, now we have, you can use processed crystals or you can use raw crystals. This is citrine, yellow color, which is used for the Manipur chakra or the solar plexus. This is jade, which is green color. It is used for the heart chakra. Since heart chakra is also involved with emotions, you can also use rose quartz, pink crystal. This is a rose quartz. For the Vishuddha chakra, we have the lapis lazuli. There are other chakra, there are other crystals like purple rainbow or indigo crystals. Lapis lazuli is also used because it has the blue color for the throat chakra. For the third eye, we have the aquamarine. You can use the aquamarine or you can use the white crystal or you can use the amethyst. And here the crown chakra, violet chakra, we use the amethyst. This is a cluster. You can use it in the processed form, which looks like this, or a pencil. Now, generally, when you use crystals for unblocking your chakras, the method is place that particular crystal on the chakra, feel the energies. You can chant the bija mantras or do silent meditation. Okay, now the next method of unblocking your chakras is a therapy which is called aromatherapy. Now in aromatherapy, generally oils are extracted. Now why these oils are used to unblock the chakras, what is the correlation is basically aromatherapy oils have got essence of plants in them. So they have living essence in them. The universal life energy is present in the oils. The oils are extracted from the seeds, fruits, flowers, resin, bark, stem, etc. of the various plants. They are generally kept in dark color bottles because the molecules of these oils release an odor when they are heated. So in order to prevent them from sunlight and in order to prevent the odor from, the smell from going out, kept in the dark bottles. Now when you use aromatherapy oils, they are used in three ways. First method would be inhaling. Second method would be massage or topical application, and third, which is very, very rarely done, and that is also done in a prescribed form, is taking them internally. Now, generally, when oils are taken internally, they actually help you to boost your immune system. So, when people have a very low immune system, there are very qualified doctors who, under prescription, recommend a person to take the oils internally in some form. When you do the topical application, generally what happens is when oils are applied in the form of massage, they stimulate the thermal receptors. What happens is when the thermal receptors of the skin are stimulated, the bacteria and the fungus are killed. So people with skin disorders are generally prescribed oils because they have fungicide. They act like a fungicide. They kill the microbacteria. The other way is when they are massaged, they go into the lymph nodes. From the lymph nodes, they pass on to the bloodstream. So that is what happens when you massage yourself with the oil. But care has to be taken because these oils are very strong. You need to take care that you do not have allergies like asthma or epilepsy, or pregnant ladies or small children need to take care because the fragrances or the odors are very strong. They might create irritation on the skin, so they are generally mixed with carrier oils. These carrier oils are very mild. When you mix them with the carrier oils and then do the massage, they don't have any adverse effect on the skin. When you inhale, what happens is when you inhale the oils, through the mucous membranes of your respiratory tract, the odors go into the lungs, and from the lungs they stimulate the brain. Now generally why oils are used and how they work, there is in our nervous system and the part of the brain, the smell, the connection of smell is done by the olfactory system. When you take a smell, when you inhale something, your olfactory system gets stimulated, and what it does is it immediately sends electromagnetic messages to the limbic system. And limbic system is a very important part of our nervous system because it is related to the heartbeat, to the blood pressure, to our breathing, to the hormonal balances, to the stress factors, and for retrieving memories. So you must have seen that when we take a particular smell, you know, if you're walking and you just smell wet soil, you remember your childhood days. Or when you smell cookies or some kind of fried savories, you suddenly remember your mom preparing those delicacies in festivals. So this is because when you inhale something, your limbic system helps you to retrieve the memories. So aromatherapy is basically used in various purposes. If the oil has got inflammation properties, it will be prescribed to you for some painful disorders. If you have skin disorders, then those particular oils would be prescribed to you which kill the bacteria and the fungus. If you have some stress or emotional disorders, then the oils which actually help to stimulate your limbic system will be prescribed to you. That is how aromatherapy works. There are some oils which are called as adaptogens because they, according to the body requirements, they adapt. So such oils are called lavender or lemon, which generally are very useful for all kinds of ailments. Lavender or lemon. Even frankincense is the best for meditation because apart from the sacral chakra or the root chakra, you can see it is basically used for stimulating all the other chakras, frankincense. So we have completed in general about the different therapies with which you can unblock your chakras. We were planning to conduct a small meditation session like we had done last time, because this is our last part of the session where we tell people that you can also unblock the chakras by creating sound frequencies or sound waves by chanting some bija mantras. So when you chant, this is a practical application which you can do right now. When you chant those bija mantras, you will be stimulating and unblocking your chakras. So here we have given a picture in